in existing SAP ECC system itself, not in the S/4HANA system, because whatever activities we are doing in the preparation phase, these activities we are carrying out in our existing system itself. Okay, so converting the customers and vendors to business partners. Now let me take you to ECC system, right? Why ECC? Because this activity would be done in the existing system, not in S/4HANA. Okay, so this is a ECC system. Now in ECC system, if I want to know, I'm going to the table just to find out some customers and vendors. Okay, so if I go for KNA1 and let's execute this. Okay, so there are, you can see different customers available here. So maybe I'll just copy some of those. Okay, let's copy this much. What I'll do now is I will open another system, another session, and I will go to table, which is a link between customer and BP. Okay, which is that table? CVI, which is customer vendor integration, underscore CUST, which means customer and link. Okay, and I'll just see whatever customers I copied, whether the business partner already exists for those customers or not. Okay, and let's execute this. So there are already some business partners available for 11, 12, 13 and 10 customer number. Okay, 11, 12, 13 and 10. So apart from 11, 12, 13 and 10, which are the others which we can take? Okay, so maybe we will take this 100. Okay, let's say now in your case, when you are migrating to S/4HANA, you may find that none of the business partner or none of the customer is available as a business partner. See, if your customer is already using SRM, CRM, there are chances that some of the customers, vendors are already available as business partners. But you need to find out which are not converted and you have to convert those. So in an example, I'm just showing you this customer number 100, which we need to migrate to business partner. Okay, and we already seen the configuration and all last time, right? If a customer is already available and we need to convert this customer to business partner, there is a configuration where you need to assign the customer account group to the BP grouping. Okay, maybe I'll show you. So you already know the reverse way. Converting BP to customer, right? Because in S/4HANA, whenever we create a customer, the BP is created first. So based on my BP, system generates the customer number. But here I want BP to be created based on my customer. Okay, so for that, the configuration is almost same. It is in the cross application components. Okay, master data synchronization. Yeah, here, master data synchronization. Okay, then you have this customer vendor integration. So this is ECC. You can see whatever things we have seen, those are available in ECC also. Business partner is not a new thing. It is available in ECC. The only new thing is that it was not mandatory in ECC. Okay, so business partner settings, settings for customer integration. Field assignment, assign keys. And if you remember last time, we discussed this one. From direction BP to customer, when we created the business partners earlier, we were creating the customers based on the BP number. And that is the reason in this configuration, BP grouping is assigned to customer account group. So if you create a BP, if I go to transaction BP, it will not ask me customer account group. It will ask me BP grouping, right? It is asking me BP grouping. So based on this BP grouping, system will determine the customer account group from this particular config. Okay, but now I want reversed one. I already have the customers with customer account group and I want to identify what would be the BP grouping for that. So that is the second activity. Let's close this. That is the second activity. Define number assignments from direction to direction customer to BP. Okay, let's open this. Okay, and you can see here are the customer account groups which are assigned to business partner grouping with the tick same number if you want. Okay, so in our case, if I want to convert customer number 100, I need to check which is the account group for this customer, and I need to make sure that this account group is assigned to the business partner grouping. So let's see what is the account group of this line. It is HDMO something. Okay, we need to assign HDMO to the business partner grouping. So if I go here, no, HDMO is not assigned. So let's click on new entry. So see, based on this, what you need to do is you already have some list of customer account groups in your ECC system. All those customer account groups must be assigned to BP grouping. Okay, so you may also need to create BP groupings, and I've shown you how to create a BP groupings when we discussed about the business partner earlier, right? So you can create one-to-one business partner groupings if you want, or you can have multiple customer account groups assigned to the same BP grouping. That is also fine. Okay, so as of now, I'm going with HDMO and 0001, which is a standard BP grouping. So what I'm telling the system that if there is a customer with customer account group HDMO, I want to assign this, I want to create this customer as BP with grouping 0001. Okay, let's save this. You are not permitted to use grouping. I think this is not related to us. There is some another group which is causing this problem. So let me remove this. Okay, and let's try to save. Number range AF for business partner grouping. Again, it is asking for ABFL. Let's remove this also. Let's try. Everything is a problem here. So TR01, let me remove this also. Okay, now seems to be okay. Okay, so now our customer account group HDMO is assigned to BP grouping 0001. Okay, now let's come out of this. Let's close this. Okay, and let's check other configurations are fine or not. So this is one configuration which is very important. Let me check if the other configurations are also okay or not. So for that, again, within customer vendor integration, you have this synchronization of mass data. Okay, let's open this. This is a program. This is a conversion cockpit which will allow us to convert the customers and vendors to BP. So if you open this, execute synchronization cockpit, the T code is MDS underscore load underscore cockpit. Master data synchronization underscore load underscore cockpit. Okay, see, there are other configurations which are also missing in this system because here it is not showing any object. Here it is not showing the synchronization process. So not a problem. Let's go out and try to do the other configurations also. So let's go to the synchronization control. Okay, again, in synchronization control, there are these configurations. So synchronization objects, activate PPO, these are not required. Let's go to the activate synchronization objects. Okay, you can see there, these are the four options. You can convert BP to customer, you can convert BP to vendor, you can convert customer to BP, and you can convert vendor to BP. And all of them are deactivated as of now in this system. Okay, so if I want to activate customer to BP and vendor to BP, let's tick on this and click on save. Okay, this is one configuration. Let me see if the other configurations are fine or not. So other configurations can be found in settings for customer integration. And we are talking about direction customer to BP. So settings for customer integration and define BP roles for direction customer to BP. So let's check for the group if the BP role is properly assigned or not. So 0001, it will create FLCU00, right? There is one thing which is missing here, so it will only create the company code segment. So for sales area segment, we have FLCU01, right? But here, because it is not explained, it is not told to the system, it will only create a company code segment, which we don't want. We also want to create a sales area segment if it is available. So I will remove this and click on save. Okay, so now I think these are the two important configurations. First one is role. Based on the BP grouping, you need to tell the system which roles you want to create. And second is based on the customer account group, which BP grouping will come into the picture. Okay, so now let's again go to the synchronization cockpit. Okay, I'll explain you again. The path is a little bit difficult to identify, but don't worry, this is the path and all is mentioned in my slides. Okay, so IMG, you can go to cross application components. Within cross application components, master data synchronization. Okay, here you need to go to synchronization of mass data and then execute synchronization cockpit. Okay, you can see this to be activated. That is the reason it is appearing here. Okay, and currently we want to convert customer to BP. So double click on this. Okay, when you double click on this, system will incorporate those things here, right? You can see. So here you need to tell the system which customer you want to convert to BP. Okay, so you can tell, I want to convert this customer, or I want to convert all the customers with a particular account group. Okay, or you can also tell the system, I don't want to convert the customers where the central deletion flag is on. Okay, so normally what we do is we are not going to convert this one by one. We want to convert all our customers in a batch, right? So normally we go with the account group option. So we tell the system, convert all the customers which are available in this account group and ignore those customers where the deletion flag is on. So we don't want to convert the customers where the deletion flag is on to the BPs. Okay, but in our case, because this is something which will take time, there might be multiple customers in the account group. So as of now, I'm keeping it simple. I'm just going to convert one single customer. Okay, but the method is same. You just need to provide the selection criteria here. So I want to convert which customer? Where the value is equal to, okay, include the value. Okay, it is equal to customer number 100, right? So I want to convert customer number 100 from customer to BP. Okay, and since this is only one single customer, let's remove this background processing and do it in the foreground. Okay, and there is an option to execute this, start the synchronization. Start this. Okay, completed. Now let's go to the table and see if in CVI underscore cust underscore link, we should be able to see customer number 100 also. Okay, let's try to refresh this. Maybe let's go out and up to 100. Let's try to execute. It is still not converted. There is something wrong. No, it is not converted. Okay, let's see. So let me take you to the I'm going to the PPT slide. There is one program. If something goes wrong, there is a program where you need to go and check what exactly is missing in the configuration. Just give me a minute. Let me start the PPT so that I can copy that program. Okay, you can see this program. Use report to check the customizing. Okay, I'm just copying this and let's go to the server again. So I see, or maybe I'll open new session. So SE38 to execute a program. Okay, let's enter this and go to execute. Okay, and I want to check in the customer settings. I want to see whether my customer settings are properly maintained or not. So just go to the customer setting and click on check and display the results. Okay, see what it is showing here is display setting for the business partner roles. Okay, so this is fine. Display settings for business partner groupings. So we just need to verify that our BP grouping. No, this is BP to customer. We need to verify this customer to BP. Yes. So here we need to verify whether our customer account group is properly assigned to BP grouping or not, which is correct. So HDMO is assigned to 0001. And here we need to identify whether our customer account group, this is customer account group, not the BP grouping. So our customer account group, which is HDMO. Yeah, that is a problem. You can see HDMO is not assigned to the BP role. Okay, so this BP roles FLCU00 and FLCU01 must be assigned to customer account group HDMO. Okay, which is missing. So in our configuration, which we are done just now. Where is that config? Let's come out of the synchronization cockpit. Okay, and in synchronization control, I think. No, sorry. It was in master data synchronization, customer vendor integration. Okay, business partner settings, settings for customer integration. This one, which we have done just now. So what we have done is we have, no, just 1 minute. Field assignment, assign keys. This is fine. This we have done properly. Direction customer to BP. Yeah, this one. So just now we created for 0001, but I suppose this is a BP grouping. This is not a BP grouping. This is a customer account group. So I have to copy this two and I have to assign HDMO here. Again, HDMO. Okay, now let's save this and then you go and verify in the customizing whether it is properly done or not. So if I refresh this report now, so HDMO, yes, should be available here. So now customer account group HDMO will create two roles, FLCU00 and FLCU01, and number range is fine. So let's again go to the synchronization cockpit. Okay, I told you the T code also. You can go through transaction MDS, which is master data synchronization, underscore load, underscore cockpit. Okay, so just execute or just double click on customer to business partner, remove this background processing mode, customer number, include a specific value where it is equal to 100. Okay, and let's try to execute this. And once this is executed, go to table and see if in BP tables this customer is created or not. So CVI underscore cust underscore link, let's try to refresh this. Yes, it is now created. Okay, so now our customer has been converted to BP. You can copy this BP. You can go to transaction BP and see whether this BP was created properly or not. But this is a customer number, right? If I want to know the BP number, again, I have to copy this. I have to go to table BUT000. Okay, BP GUID is a link between business partner and customer. right? You should remember all these things. If you're not practiced, please do it because this is very important. So BPG UID and execute, this will give me the business partner number. So business partner is generated with this number. So now if I go to transaction BP, and if I want to search for this particular business partner, you can see this was the customer which was created till now in SAP ECC system. Now even in SAP ECC itself, it has been converted to business partner, okay, with FLCU 00 and FLCU 01 roles. Okay, so if I want to go to the company code data, you can see company code data is also copied for this particular customer. Okay, it is available only for one company. So if it is available for multiple company codes, that also